Hello and welcome to episode 3 of All About Seoul. In today's episode, we're gonna visit the 5 top Starbucks in Seoul.
I'm going to be taking you to one of the most extraordinary, bizarre and beautiful Starbucks locations around Seoul. We're gonna go around Seoul and we're gonna try every trendy, very famous and very style original Starbucks in Seoul. One of the really fun facts about Starbucks here in Korea is Koreans love to gift Starbucks coupons. I was so shocked about it. Every time there's like a thank you or like a birthday or whatever, they just give you a Starbucks coupon. And I got a $50 Starbucks coupon on my birthday, and it's $50, so I don't know how much matcha I can drink. We're gonna spend this coupon today and we're gonna try every Starbucks and see why each location is really special from the other.
To reach the first Starbucks on our list today, I took the subway and I got out at Ewha Women's University Station, exit 3. Today we are in the first Starbucks ever that opened in South Korea in July 27, 1999, and it's right here behind me. This Starbucks was upgraded and it became a reserve Starbucks, which means it's a premium Starbucks. We're gonna take a tour inside and we're gonna try the reserve premium Starbucks coffee. Let's go.
Do, 안 눌러도 되는 건가?
네, 녹화 중인 것 같은데요.
사진 찍고 가실래요?
I was so lucky when I came on this day. I had no idea that they were having an event. And I took a picture with a cute Starbucks teddy bear. Inside the cafe, you can see a lot of medals and like trophies and even pictures from the 1990s of this cafe. Here on these tables, the baristas were serving coffee for the guests. And after waiting for around 10 minutes, it was my turn. I sat down and the barista started explaining to me about their special coffee, and they gave us 2 cups of coffee that were actually free. Here I was with these very cute girls that I met. Such a really fun coincidence. After trying these 2 coffees, they also gave us a small gift, which is a sample of the coffees that we tried. I took the subway again to our second destination of the day, and I got out at Jeki-dong Station, exit 2. You have to actually walk in Gyeongdong Market, and it was a bit difficult to find the location. But once I found it, I was really happy because it was really worth the search. Moving on to Starbucks Gyeongdong 1960. This Starbucks is actually located in Gyeongdong Market. The location is the 5th community stores, and it is incorporated with a retro decoration with the theme of a theater from the 1960s.
Now I am so excited to take you on this Starbucks behind me. So you're gonna be shocked when you see the interior inside. It is so beautiful. And it is so original, and it's gonna be one of our favorite destinations for today. Let's go and see how it looks inside.
Mm-hmm. This Starbucks was restored from a Gyeongdong theater, which was originally built in the 1960s and was closed since 1994. In this location, actually, the menu was much more diverse than any other location, and they have a special pastry that's only available in this location. Oh my god, that was so easy! Traditional Hanok Starbucks. Wow! Okay, even though the map said to get off exit 6, but I think exit 1 is better because there's no like the pedestrian road to cross to the other side. So exit 1 is the best, not exit 6. I'm gonna go in the subway again and get out of exit 1. Okay, this is it. This is Hanok-style Starbucks. It's located near City Hall Station and Seoul Plaza and Deukseong Palace. Interior of this Starbucks is actually very unique because it's very similar to a Hanok style where you can walk inside and they have some seats on a platform where you should take your shoes off in order to sit on. It's actually pretty small, so when you go there you can just enjoy the sitting on these platforms, which is what I did.
지금.
Now to our fourth Starbucks destination. I took the subway to Express Bus Terminal Station and I got out of exit 4. Welcome to Starbucks Reserve Famille Park. We are at Express Bus Terminal Exit 4 and this is the trendiest Starbucks in entire Seoul, and it's also named as the most beautiful Starbucks in Seoul. I'm gonna go inside. Actually, I'm really full. We're gonna just take a tour inside Starbucks and after that we have to go to the last Starbucks destination before the sun sets, because I want to see the sunset in the last destination. It is one of the biggest highlights in this video. This location, Starbucks Famille Park, it was really easy to find. Actually, it's literally near the subway exit. The Starbucks is shaped like a dome, and the sight of the artificial birds inside fluttering towards the ceiling looks like a fairy tale. Marking the 800th store in South Korea, this Starbucks invites customers to enjoy their coffee in an urban coffee forest style. So I got my limited edition pink something juice, whatever the name it is. It's really sweet. A lot of the drinks here are like, to be honest, like they are crazy sweet. Oh my god, so cute. For my last and final destination of the day, finishing it at the fifth Starbucks, I actually took the bus and it was really close. I went to Jamwon. I got off at Jamwon Hanshin stop. Now this is our last destination and it's Starbucks Wave Art Center. This was opened in 2019. The Seoul Wave Art Center made a buzz online for its innovative concept. This building looks like a cruise ship floating on the water. Welcome to the floating Starbucks. This is our last destination. Starbucks at Seoul Wave Art Center. We finally made it. Oh my God. We literally arrived in the best time ever because the sun is setting right now and the weather is just like perfect. Perfect. Oh my god, I'm so happy to see it. This is the first time actually for me coming to all these branches of Starbucks. Oh, Oh, how beautiful. Here at Jamwan Station, Starbucks Seoul Wave Art Center, which is the floating Starbucks on Han River, is by far my favorite. I'm so happy I came here at the end. I was able to see the sunset and it was just like the perfect end for the day. The cafe here is gorgeous. The location is literally 10 over 10. You can spend your day at the park having picnic and then you can come here, watch the sunset. It's gorgeous. I love it so much. So since I wanted to spend the 50,000 won today in these five Starbucks, at the end, I still had 18,000 won. So I decided to go to the application and buy just any random tumbler that I find for 18,000. And this is the one that I picked out. That was it, everyone. The top five Starbucks in Seoul with a $50 gift certificate that I used. You can find all the locations of these five Starbucks that I went to in the description box. If you like this video and you want to see more about stuff in Seoul and especially this kind of video all about Seoul, please hit the like button, put for me a comment, and don't forget to subscribe and support my channel. I love you so much. Thank you.